name is Eric Holswilder. I'm regional manager for specified technologies. We manufacture fire stopping devices, as you might know. And I'm doing today a short presentation on a CPR. And the code of practices that are being used in combination with that. So we'll start with a
short. Yeah, it's
short. Yeah, you can do that as well.
CPR. Yeah.
The key construction regulation.
If you regulation. Do these things properly, you don't get to do CPR.
That's.
I will be wasted like that.
We are both divers, that's why we know from.
I'm a seaman by training, so I even went to hospital for 2 weeks during my training.
Oh, okay.
That's serious.
because if you're on the ship, you cannot call a doctor, you have to do it yourself.
Yeah.
So. But for 2 weeks you must have learned many things, not that. CPR.
Surgery.
No, we didn't.
Sewing.
We did the sewing. We did the. We were present at surgery.
Cutting.
Yeah, which was not everybody's joyful. Joyful game, but hey, if necessary, you do have to do these things. Yeah. And sometimes with a headset on and hoping that the doctor understands what you're saying.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Language barriers issues.
So, PD 41-2018 here in Greece is a code of practice by which is a new body formed in Greece in 2018. And this will have their first conference in, I think, in February next year. Here in Athens. They've taken over the explanation to the market of the new standards regarding the construction product regulations. Then EN5575 on the cabling side, power control cables, basically everything from 230 volts onwards. Yeah. And what we are seeing here most of the time, ISO 11801 is our bread and butter. EN50355 and 343, selection and installation of fire resistant power and control cable systems. So basically your emergency light system, the emergency operational system of a building, ensuring that automated fire doors close, etc. These kind of very important systems. And 5174, insulation technology, cabling insulation, also partly in our field, in the data center, in the data cabling. But we tend to treat everything as loose components rather than as a complete part. And this is what the CPR is trying to achieve. That we, instead of looking at all these standards individually, we start to combine this. What is the background for this development? Of course, some disasters. The first one is the Windsor Tower in Madrid that burned down in the late 90s. The second one is an apartment in a block in London. There is a fire in a fire in Sheffield in the UK, and last but not least, Grenfell Tower in London, most recently.
Yeah.
And these fires could spread so easily because people were saving money on safety related issues. And one of the outcomes of the jury that was investigating all this was that value engineering does not belong in the building industry, because value engineering means that you're taking the cheapest product and you expect the best performance, and that doesn't go together. Simple as that. And unfortunately, the lower part is not so well visible here, with the cableway, gasoline or wood, but basically it says a cable tray, once it starts burning, it has more fuel than gasoline or a kilogram of wood. Yeah, so also something that we tend to forget. Now with the standards being implemented, we hope that of course the cabling becomes halogen-free, flame retardant, self-extinguishing, etc. But that's where we need to push the industry to, from a legislative point of view. Now, how would this work? PD41 and 2451-86. And this is basically this is a Greek standard, or a Greek piece of legislation that is applicable to the building industry, and especially the electrical parts of the building industry. It has all to do with fire safety management, provisions of escape routes and means of escape. So if you have a two-story building, it might be a fire ladder outside. If it's a 30-story building, you need to have specific staircases that are fire safe for minimum 2 hours, I would say. Structural protection of the building, and also it's all aimed at saving lives at the end. So the EN5575 is coming on the market. In 2017 it became mandatory for cabling, and that was a big wake-up call, I would say, for the whole industry, because all of a sudden our cables that we used to be using did not comply anymore, because the standards were just slightly different. You will see that there is a need for a DOP, a declaration of performance. Yeah. And the cabling in Europe needs to have CE marking. Now CE marking was voluntary up to then, and since 2017 it has become mandatory. Yeah. So in a lot of places, especially public buildings, airports, these kind of event halls, there will be a need also to refurbish the cabling, because they don't no longer comply with the regulations, which might be good for the industry. Should be good for us as well. You know? But okay, there will be exceptions to the rule, because you cannot shut an airport down. Because they don't have the money at the moment to refurbish everything. I don't think they will let us do that. Yeah. And especially for cabling, you'll find a number of cable classifications for the reaction to fire, meaning whether the fire will spread along the cable, or will it be self-extinguishing. In case of a fire, will many flaming droplets fall from the cable down droplets while you were trying to get, to run away. And the main used, or what most people are aiming for, is the C class for the cabling, because that's right in the middle of everything. It does not have any burning droplets. It's basically a cable in that also meets IEC 60332. There's 2C or 224. So that is what would be the standard requirement. On other building products, there's requirements for a constructed from the construction product regulation already came much earlier. On the fire stopping, because it's a building, seen as a building material, it was directly from 2011 onwards where it was required to have an ETA and CE marking. And in some countries like Germany, you also need some additional legislation to fulfill, because the Germans, in most of the countries, the ETA is sufficient, so the European testing is sufficient, because European law overrules local laws, especially on the building site. In Germany, it's the other way around. They turned it around because the Bundesländer in Germany, they said, no, we're not. The government might agree with this, but we don't. So each of the German Bundesländer have their own building law. And so you have 16 or 17 different Bundesländer in Germany, and each of them has a different, slightly different building wall. Makes life easy. So I'm glad Greece is following the ETAs. Really do. And the A1 extension in 2017 on the CPR was for the cabling. Requirements is mainly on the reaction to fire, which is in the table before. And the cables have a class, a zero class, and they need to have a DOP and a have a CE marking. Strangely enough, at the moment, the cable management systems are not in the scope, and circuit integrity is also not in the scope of the CPR.
So you mean that if we use plastic face?
No, there is. That is exactly the point. You still could use plastic, however, the Greek code of practice says you should not use plastic, it should be metallic.
Where?
Everywhere.
Because if you use surface isolation, one of the room, you cannot reconnect.
You can, because it's not prohibited. Yeah, and I think in at Le Grand in France, they're still manufacturing tons and tons and tons of plastic.
I can tell you for cable management, the issue. The issue. The fire rating, some manufacturers, they want to promote the terms LSNH, something like this on cable management. They will say, oh, it's zero halogen.
Yeah.
Us manufacturers, Le Grand and others, were against it because that term is not linked to a test method or to a result. We can say it's LSNH, how much smoke? And how much halogen? Because it's not zero, it's still acid.
Yeah.
And so we are against it, and this is why it's blocking the development, is because how do you test the cable management to this? What size cable management of the passing? So there's really no test existing, and we're against the terminology that's being proposed by some others. Yes. So right now, this is not moving very fast. It is moving now in Brussels. I just
heard. I've heard something similar.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's finally starting to get some traction again. I hope with the new commission being installed that it will start moving once more. Also, in my view, worrying is that circuit integrity cables are not in the CPR, because those are our lifeline at the end of the day. Yeah, those are hooked up to your emergency lighting, to your to the motors of the elevators that bring the firemen up and down, to the pump, the motors of the pumps that drive the sprinkler system. So this is crucial, and I think it's very, very strange that those cables are not included in the CPR.
Because this is about how long the cables might last. CPR is about what smoke it emits.
Yes, but all those circuit integrity cables are low smoke, zero halogen, minimum. They're tested to the same or similar standards as the fire-rated barriers. So you would imagine that they would have been included in this. So, talking about disasters, it's always a nice topic. We're looking at protection towards or against thermal effects. And I do not mean the thermal effects the fire has on people. I mean the thermal effect it has on the cabling system during installation, and because of that, potentially endangering people that are trying to escape from a building in an emergency event. Very important, cables does not encroach on escape routes until they meet the relevant IEC 60332, meaning they don't have falling droplets, they don't they're self-extinguishing, and they are low smoke zero halogen. And I totally underwrite your statement, Gauthier, because there is still some halogen allowed. It's better than the LSF that we used to have in the past. Those smoke and flames, it was even worse. It could be anything. And also important is that cables encroaching escape routes must be provided with mechanical protection against damage. Yeah. So, and there you see that there is a call for metallic or at least sturdy cable management, sturdier than PVC encasements. So most of the time it will be automatically a metallic cable tray or a wire. So if you look at the definition, what is an escape route? Is the designated path to get out of the building in case of an emergency. So, as mentioned before, the cable must meet at IEC 60332 as a minimum. A cable not embedded in the non-combustible material is not otherwise protected also reflecting back to the ISC 6033. Standards. If you follow EIC 6032 for the cabling part, you are on the safe side. EN50174. Here there are some changes. The general requirements for cables in escape routes is now to be followed throughout the building. Yeah, that means you have to have a good cable management system that that you can use seamlessly, whether it's an escape route area or a normal part of the building. Same for the cabling. Yeah, and that is important. Because that means that the cable standard needs to be higher. And also because the buildings are changing over time, we see a lot of needs to ensure that these are adaptable also from the existing cabling point of view. So you don't have to change your cable routing just because you're changing the use of a room in the building. Performance on telecommunication cabling, installation cables should meet CCA, Euroclass, being fire resistant, no droplets, and self-extinguishing as key characteristics. All of the telecommunications cables meet at least ECA. And ECA also has no droplets as a requirement. Or meet EN60332 attachment. But when it comes all together, yeah, so basically the one of the first slides that I showed you, we tend to look at all the standards as loose components, but the reality is in the building, it needs to be a complete system approach. So you need to have it to be influenced by all the standards, all the applicable standards, in order to meet the requirements of the CPR. And that, I think, is another way of thinking that requires some modifications in our designs, and it requires also a modification in our attitude towards the construction products, towards cabling in buildings. If you look at the building once more, now you have some different areas designated as a intended to do was actually take maybe a piece of trunking or a closed cable tray to bridge the escape route. But in case of an emergency or a fire, this still is dangerous. So what you see now is that the cables are being supported or need to be supported to avoid premature collapse. You see that there's little containment required on the clips, so they are strong enough. A little story about the Berlin airport. The service tunnel underneath the airport, main airport building, is 1.5 kilometers long, and it's full of circuit integrity cables. And the cable management is excellent. Only the way the wall is not suitable for this purpose because it's gaseous concrete blocks, but it's sandstone. Get a gaseous sandstone instead of normal fire rated ones, and the plugs used are plastic. So welcome to Germany, and Tesla is going to build a new factory there. So you see the building areas, they're basically all standardized to the same standard as you would need for an escape route. So in case of an incident, you could also leave fire one of those rooms instead. If for instance the designated escape route was blocked. Supported in, to avoid the premature collapse. Previously, this was only a requirement on the escape route. Now it's a requirement throughout the building. So that's, I think, is a big change for all of us. Current landscape and regular energy environment form lessons to be learned. So basically, looking back, what kind of incidents we had in the past, whether it's Grenfell or the Windsor Tower, Düsseldorf Airport, some of the other terrible incidents that we had in the past, those all need to be taken into consideration, and they form also a basis for the new standards, because we want to avoid repeating those errors that we had. And of course, specifying is a key word in getting the right materials in the building in the future. That was it from my side. Any questions?